Okay. So, where are we? When different now.
Wait.
One is the deep samskara. Then new vasana, new samskara has to be created. Now samskara is related to your life. Ishta Devata mantra is given, which is Ishta Devata Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Bhagavate Vasudevaya, whatever is that. Now this mantra is associated with deity, Devata. Now as you start thinking about Devata, your mind gets purified and filled with the qualities of the Devata. Shiva's qualities are Vairagya and Jnana, okay, wisdom. Okay, so those who are devotees of Shiva, as they chant and think of Shiva, the mind will get purified with the divine qualities of Shiva. So the whole process of mantra is creating new impressions in your mind, overwriting the old impressions. The most damaging old impressions are ego, self-identity. So that is removed and new identity, new positive qualities are filled in your life. That positive quality is of the divine. So this, when you start chanting about Shiva, the mind will get filled with Shiva's qualities. When you chant about Narayana, the qualities of Narayana fill you. And whatever you think, actually, whatever you chant, you become that. So this is the mantra. Okay. So now, when you chant, starting chanting mantra, obviously we are associating name with the form. Our starting of life is name with the form. Vaishali means one chami chami, right? Lady, that's for me here. For husband, it may look other way. Depending on your each name is also for, okay, right? So obviously, we name is name of Shiva. We associate the form called Shiva. Somebody sitting in Kailasa. Okay, and obviously we are also troubled in life, marriage and family and all. Shiva is also troubled, sitting in Kailasa. So our association starts like that. Okay, so I have a vehicle to go in, vehicle here. And that vehicle cannot go on top of Himalaya, so we have Shiva also has a vehicle. So all sorts of, and I have a home here made out of this thing. And Kailas also, Shiva has a cave. Like that we start associating initially to start with. Okay. So then gradually as we chant mantra, we understand that Shiva is not just a body. Shiva is nothing but mind. The qualities of Shiva, which is Jnana and Vairagya. So we start getting attracted to that quality. Then gradually as you understand, oh, how did that quality come in Shiva? Then mind is controlled by intellect. So Shiva has had some deeper understanding of life, that intellect is Shiva. So that understanding comes. Then gradually understanding comes, I am not different from Shiva. The same Shiva in him and me is same. So this understanding comes. So this journey of spiritual evolution is called Salokya, Samipya, Sarupya and Sayujya. First you feel that Salokya, we are in the same loka, God and me. Okay? I eat, God eats. Okay? I sleep and we make God also sleep. We wake up God with Suprabhata. So all my qualities I superimpose on God and God's quality is superimposed on us. Okay? So that starts with the my quality superimposing on God will start. Okay? I'll make God, feed God, prasad, naivedyam. Okay? Then I'll dress God, I'll, do whatever as human being I do, I try to put on God. That's called one is. Then whatever God does, we also impose on us. Okay. That's where the qualities of the devotee first level, you see, he starts putting Nama, Shankha, Chakra. Okay, Nama means, okay, the Shankha Chakra is, Lord carries the Shankha and Chakra. I can't carry physical Shankha and Chakra. I carry Shankha Chakra symbols. Like that you start. That's called Salokya. So you bring God to your loka and you go to your God's loka. Both are, you become, that's what's happening. Right? So this is the first stage of a what you call us relationship. This happens with the boy and girl. Okay. So I mean, I'm saying there's a matching taking place. Hey, you are wearing pink dress. I'm also wearing pink. Same. Like that. You are trying to find commonality. Okay. So this is the first level of spiritual journey. I am trying to find commonality between me and God. God is higher and greater. I am small. Okay, but then we are trying to see some commonality. That's called Salokya. Then becomes Samipya. We become closer. Okay? Samipya means we start understanding the God is nothing but the divine is nothing but divine qualities. Shiva is nothing but Vairagya. Shiva is nothing but Jnana. Okay? This we start understanding. So we understand from Salokya, we move to Samipya. We come closer to Shiva. Then comes the Sarupya. There is so much of deep understanding between the divinity and myself, right? Then there is no difference between me and him in mentally. So there are many of my students, okay? They write everything. I don't even know that I have written. And written by Guruji. Prabhuji. Their minds have become properly my mind. Okay, now I wonder, I also get confused. Oh, I have spoken like this somewhere sometime. So now they can think like Guruji, they can think right like Guruji. Okay, they are properly Guru. Okay, so clear. Actually, then anybody says something, no, Guruji will not say like that because they know very clearly Guruji cannot. There is a matching of the mind, Sarupya will happen. No, Guruji cannot say like that. Probably Guruji may say, but they're very clear. The mind is the mirror that's matched properly. Okay? That's called Sarupya. Same thing happens with the divinity. Okay? Narayana will say like this in this situation. Narayana will act like this. Shiva knows, I know Shiva will do this. You come to such a clarity about divinity that there's a matching completely, Sarupya. Okay, that's called Samipya. Sarupya is that action of the divinity will happen through you. Now you have to get it translated to work. Shiva's work is Jnana, Yoga. Okay. Narayana's work is Palana, Poshana. So now you become a miniature representation of the divinity on the earth. You also start doing that. Rama is Dharma. So you also become embodiment of Dharma on the earth. So you become Sarupya. You will take the Rupa of that God. Divinity, Ishta Devata. Then comes the Sayujya. There is no difference between you and divinity. In your dreams also, you cannot think of the difference between you and the God. You and the divinity. Okay? That amount of oneness will experience. So, these are all effects of mantra. Now, you can ask me any question now. Yes, Rupaji. Abracadabra. I don't know whether I said these things at that time. I also a little bit improved in my life.
Angi one solpa chitta amela antakarana one solpa fine line idhe yen idhe anta define.
Okay, what is antakarana and what is chitta? That's the question. Antakarana is inner instrument. Okay. So I have senses, I have body, 5 sense organs of action. Senses and 10 organs are there. Now, this experiences through this, I experience through an inner instrument, inner vehicle. That's called antakarana. Anta means inner instrument. Okay, that has 4 aspects: manas, buddhi, ahankara, chitta. There are 4 aspects of the antakarana. Now, if you, the moment you start thinking that these 4 are different as different things, okay, they are not. The 4 are the same instrument operating in different ways. Manas, buddhi, ahankara, chitta. The same aspect, the same mind our same consciousness taking different roles is called Manas, Buddhi, Ahankara, Chitta. The Manas is the conceptualizing engine. Okay, I get some image through senses. So the Manas conceptualizes, questions. Oh, what is this? Okay, this is a boy or a girl. This is what, boat. There is a conceptualization which is being done by the mind. Manas. Manas is the lower aspect, which handles the sense organs directly. The input from sense organs is collected by the mind and conceptualized. There's a conceptualization takes place. Oh, is this possibly a boat? Is this possibly a flower? That conceptualization takes place. Then there is Buddhi, is a decision maker. Okay, it says, it is a flower, go and pluck it. Buddhi is the decision maker. The Ahankara is the identity which influences the Buddhi, the self-identity. Okay. Now the same situation can be pursued by different beings in different way. A cow standing in front of your house early morning, a beautiful cow, can be a divine being, divine divinity standing in front of your house. Okay. So now the same cow can be a good meal for somebody. The same cow can be source of milk for somebody. Same cow can be money for somebody. So this, depending on your vasanas, depending on your identity, that identity is ego, okay, your decision making will be very different. That vasana, cumulative vasana, is called ahankara. This root of that ahankara is my identity. So that my identity influences the buddhi. Okay. I am from such and such a community. Oh, the cow is so something for me. Okay. Because I am so and so, the cow is. Our relationship with the world is based on our identity. That identity is ahankara. And ahankara influences buddhi. If ahankara is not there, buddhi will operate purely. If your identity doesn't influence buddhi, your whole process will be very different. Okay. The ahankara can be sattvic, rajasic, tamasic, depending on your quality. So that influences the buddhi. Buddhi decision making is chained based on the ahankara. Right? The way you feel you are will make a difference. Right? So that's called ahankara. Now where is the ahankara gaining strength? Ahankara is gaining strength from your impressions, memories, chitta. What is your identity? I am a woman. Okay. I am coming from such and such a religion. I am coming from such a society. These are all nothing but impressions which are embedded in your consciousness, memory. So this is the impression, accumulated impressions in your life is called chitta. So sense organs give inputs to manas. Manas will conceptualize. This is possible, this is possible. It can't make a decision. Oh, this is also possible, this is also possible. Then Buddhi says, this is what it is, and says, tell the mind, do this. Buddhi is deeply influenced by ahankara, my identity. Okay, I am a woman, I am a man, I am a businessman, I am intelligent, I am smart. This will influence the Buddhi. Now that I am so and so is a cumulative impressions which are then the mana, already memory. It can be memory. It's called chitta. Whatever is stored. So unconsciously we live with the ahankara and chitta inputs and take the buddhi makes the decision. Now the whole of spiritual journey is this ahankara aspect, which is self-identity, has to be remodified, remodeled, changed to a better. Changing to a better is called dharma. Dropping the ahankara is called moksha. Liberation. Any questions?
Absorbing. All these mudras associated with mantra.
What mudra?
Some people, this mudra, then mantra along with that.
See, the mudra, mudra means, is a posture of the body. Chin mudra,
yes.
Then Garuda mudra, all this mudra. Okay, this is actually a posture of the body. Because body and mind are related. Okay? So somebody sitting in the room. Body is like this. Why? The body posture is called mudra. What happened? I proposed to a girl, yeah, she rejected. Oh. Body has gone like this. Somebody is sitting. Why? Hey, I got a promotion today. Your body posture changed on the mind. Now you can change your mind posture depending on the body. That's called mudra.
Some people associate this mudra and say that in particular mudra, you tell a chant a mantra, it will have effect on...
See, very simple. Mind affects the body and body affects the mind. Okay? Body affects the mind is called mudra and mantra also affects the body, mind. So both together you use. Any questions? What are you speaking? I have to sit silently.